everybody. Just to make things clear, this isn't part of the Spyro marathon. That was just the trilogy. Now that I got that out of the way, I've been meaning to talk about a certain game in the Spyro franchise. An infamous one that I've been meaning to talk about. A game declared to originally come from the deepest layers of hell. The same layer where Freddy got fingered below. Oh yeah, people say it's that bad. That game is Spyro Enter the Dragonfly. Is it that bad? Is it that miserable of an experience? Well, one thing's for sure, it had a rocky development. Even too much to stuff into this video, but to give a very brief summary of just what the hell happened. Well, for starters, Insomniac Games no longer had the rights to Spyro after the three games deal with Universal ended. Universal then got Equinox Digital for the game's art and Check 6 Studio for the actual game. That doesn't sound bad until you realize Check 6 struggled to pay their developers by always missing paychecks. They were pressured to rush out the game for the Christmas season. All this while Check 6 and Equinox moved into a single office space several months into the game's development. Needless to say, both companies ended up shutting down after the game's release. Not to mention, in 2007, a parent filed a lawsuit against Universal, Check 6, Equinox, and Sony for having a child gain seizure after playing Enter the Dragonfly. A big yikes in my opinion. For this review, I'll be playing the GameCube version, not because of it having an advantage over the PS2 version, it's just more convenient. So after witnessing the most terrifying thing ever, it turns out that the dragons are celebrating getting their dragonflies. Which, if you think about it, doesn't make any sense. They showed in the first game that only Spyro had a dragonfly, and even then it wasn't for some celebration, it was for protection. It makes even less sense when you remember the other dragons don't have dragonflies. It's as if this celebration was a very last minute thing. But the meaningless party is then interrupted by Ripto and his two minions. Maybe it makes sense for his two goons to show up since we technically don't kill them in Spyro 2. Ripto on the other hand, why is he here? You died from lava! You can't survive from lava! How did you survive? But what evil thing does he do? He takes away all the dragonflies, of course. I mean, that's the most logical thing to do. Duh! In actuality, he basically just scattered them all over the place. That's dumb! Sparks is also taken away. Ooh, something interesting. Now that Sparks is missing, how are things gonna go?
Sparks! I thought I lost you, pal.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me!
Now there's one thing I need to get out of the way. This game can get pretty good So instead of just telling you the numerous glitches I got throughout the game, I'm just gonna show you.
I was frozen today!
A few graphical errors and that's pretty much it. I didn't get the air swimming thing, and I especially didn't do the one that just straight up lets you go to the final boss. I mean, let's be honest, if I really did that, then what would be the point of me reviewing the game if I haven't even played it in its entirety? With that being said, the frame rate also suffers a lot. Things constantly slow down even if there isn't a lot on screen. Now, it might be my crappy setup, but the slowdowns happened to me more than once. But anyway, Spyro controls about the same as he's been in the three games, except his walking speed has been decreased so much that he walks like a sloth. Luckily, charging feels just as good, if not a little better, than the trilogy. This time you're collecting baby dragonflies, meaning that you now have different breaths. You have the regular fire, then you have bubbles. Bubble breath sucks. It only has one purpose, and even then, that one purpose is not fun because the baby dragonflies for some reason run away from you and tease you. So you gotta play an awkward game of cat and mouse, and this sucks. The others aren't that much better. Electric also only has one purpose, and so does freeze. But man, whoever named the baby dragonflies, what are these names? Most of these don't even sound like real names. But hey, another positive is the music. Once again composed by Stuart Copeland. Although his work here isn't as good as the trilogy, it's still pretty good. The mini games are here, but they're not really worth talking about because they're not that good. Positive time once again. They did a decent-ish job converting PS1 graphics to PS2. It may not be as colorful as the trilogy, but damn, this still looks pretty good. Except some of the character designs. Some of them look gross. Positive time too. Moneybags only appears once. And that's a blessing in disguise. Unfortunately, that also means that the characters from the previous games barely make an appearance. Hunter is only in the intro, ending, and first world. Bianca is not even the first world, just in the intro and ending. We meet Bartholomew again, but not Bentley. And pretty much the only boss is Ripto, the final boss. And he's not much of a challenge either. So that was Spyro Enter the Dragonfly, and it's not very good. In a way, it reminds me of my very old videos where I wasn't really good with editing, but in a way, that's part of the charm. But at least, it's better than the Legend of Spyro games. For me, comparing Spyro Enter the Dragonfly to the Legend of Spyro trilogy, it's like comparing Indiana Jones at the Temple of Doom to Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. One technically did a lot more different things compared to the other, and thus had more chances of doing those different things wrong, but ends up being more memorable because of those different things. While the other one doesn't really try to risk anything and ends up being safe and generally unmemorable. I mean, sure, it functions more, but are they really fun? The Legend of Spyro trilogy for me is an absolute bore fest. While Enter the Dragonfly, sure, it's done more wrong things, but you can still have fun with the glitches. And that does it for Enter the Dragonfly, so thank you guys for watching, and I'll... Oh no. That's Hunter. No. No. Oh, thank God it was just a dream. Well, thank you for watching and see you around. I gotta get out of here.